Hey guys, Metal Viking 82 here, back to show some more plunder that I have acquired here recently. This time it is going to be the 13th floor edition. So called because, as I said in my previous video, I got so much shit between there and stuff that I had pre-ordered and had coming in the mail anyway, and stuff that I picked up through the store, that there was just no way I could show everything in one video. It would be take me fucking forever, it seemed like, and I didn't want to make a super huge video. I mean, the last minute was probably 20 minutes or better. So, anyway, I actually took, I think, 23 CDs out of my collection that I just didn't want anymore. And I took them to the 13th floor for store credit because out of anywhere I've ever taken stuff into trade, he always gives me the best deal. And he gave me, I think, $100 worth of credit. And it ended up covering one album in particular and then a few others. And I'm going to show that one last because it's kind of a, I guess you'd say, a more recent Holy Grail item for me that it actually didn't take me very long to find and I was really surprised by. But I actually ended up coming back with, like, I think three more CDs than what I left with. So as you can see, I've got a huge box of stuff to show you. I'm going to set this up here and hopefully not knock everything over. I'm going to show the newer stuff first because most of this is used, and what I love about his used section that is that unless it's something like really out of print or just hard to find that he can get a little bit more money out of, most of his used CDs are $5. So that gives me, you know, a lot of leeway as far as, you know, doing blind buys. If something looks interesting to me, you know, I feel I didn't spend a whole lot on it, and I can always either take it back later for credit on my, you know, to get some new stuff, or I can trade it or whatever. But the first one is one that I've been after for a long, long time, and this came out in, what, 98? And just could never seem to find it. It's been on my Amazon wish list forever, and I was really shocked to see that he had this. This is a Daemon Arc with Hermeticum. And if you're not familiar with this, this is a side project featuring members of Moonspell, playing kind of melodic black metal, and a lot different than Moonspell's sound. And it's actually one of the members is the vocalist of Moonspell, though in this one he actually goes under the name, if I can find it. I thought it said his name on here somewhere, but I forget what he goes under. But yeah, basically it's the vocalist of Moonspell. This is kind of his project. Next up, got the new Pain album. God, what is it called? I forget. Coming Home. God, totally spaced it there. I love Pain. If you don't know who Pain is, it's basically a solo project of Peter Tagrin. Kind of playing almost, I want to say, Rammstein-ist style. Metal, but I really enjoy this album here. I've listened to it twice now, and pretty much after Dancing with the Dead, his albums didn't seem quite as heavy sounding as the others, and the last couple were okay, but this is definitely a step up, I think. Also got the new Gorgoroth, Instinctus Bestialis. I know a lot of people panned this album, and it definitely has a more death metal feel to it, not only with the new vocalist, but a lot of the music, a lot of the riffing. There is a couple tracks that have some very old school Gorgoroth, that distinct Gorgoroth sounding riff to it. But overall, definitely a more death metal oriented album. Next up, got the new Defeated Sanity, Disposal of the Dead. Really good stuff. I really only lack, like, one album. The disc is kind of giving me fits there, so I don't want it to pop out on me. But there's really only, like, one album that I'm missing from them. I think it's Psalms on the Moribund, but I just cannot seem to find that anywhere. Next up, the new Elysian, Proponent for Sentence. Haven't listened to this one just yet, but I'm definitely looking forward to it. I really love the album art on this. Another one that I haven't got a chance to spin yet, the new Nails, You Will Never Be One of Us. Kind of sucks to hear that this band seems like it I know they said they're on hiatus, but it seems like a lot of people seem to think they're done, and that's really a shame because these guys are fucking amazing. Also picked up the new Brujeria, Pocho Aztlan. Love Brujeria, especially the earlier stuff, so I'm interested to hear how this new one sounds. And the last new one is Full Blown Chaos, Heavy Lies the Crown. Got some hardcore action going here. Very Conan-inspired artwork, definitely. Alright, now on to all the used ones. I'm going to do the kind of oddball one out. And I'm sure when Brett, who's the owner of 13th Floor, was going through my stack of used stuff, because I took all this big old stack over to him so he can take it out of security cases while I started looking through everything else. And, you know, you got, like, you know, all this black metal, it seems, because he seems to get a lot of used black metal in there. And he got to the bottom of the pile and saw this, and I'm sure I kind of overheard him talking to the guys in the store. And, yeah, it was definitely a shock for him. But that's the Grateful Dead with Wake of the Flood. I do enjoy some Grateful Dead every now and then, kind of a little change of pace, and yeah, been slowly picking up their stuff, so when I saw that in there for $5, I had to get it. Next, we have Black Funeral with Vukalak. Been wanting to get Black Funeral for a while, and this makes the second one that I've gotten here recently, so very happy with that. This one, total blind buy. As I said, a lot of these were blind buys. Some of these I knew the name, but never heard the music. And others were just complete, total unknowns to me. And then there was a couple that I actually knew and I've heard before. But this is Chrome with The Haunting Presence. Really cool logo there. And what's nice is that I usually get on my phone and go on Metal Archives, and I try to at least look up who these bands are, what style they play, what they're kind of all about, and get a general feel for it. I mean, I don't really trust a whole lot of the reviewing on there, but, you know, it kind of gives me an idea of what I might be in for. So, and like I said, for $5, you can't really lose in that situation. Next is Ovsky with Malignant. Very cool artwork on here. Next is Hakavitz with Katun, I believe this is how it's pronounced. And I also noticed, besides him getting a lot of black metal in there, he seems to get most of it seems to be on Moribund Records. It's like, I think just about most of these that I've shown so far, when I look at the back of them, they're on Moribund. Next, Rimfrost with Veralder Nagli. This is one that I have heard of before, but never actually heard them. Next, Im Sinfonia with In Morning Symphony. This is their debut EP, I do believe. Features Paul Kerr from November's Doom on vocals. I was really surprised to see that, because I do enjoy November's Doom. I love Paul Kerr's vocals, both his growl and his clean vocals. Next up is Hrigz, I believe is how it's pronounced, H-R-I-Z-G, with Anthems to Decrepitude. Again, really cool artwork, and as you can see, Moribund, another Moribund. Like I said, something about Moribund Records. He just seems to get a lot of their stuff in there. Next is In Memoriam with Lost to Antiquity. I really like the logo on this, and I really like the artwork. It's just very interesting. Looks like something out of a, strange museum. Next three are all by the same band. A one-man project, I do believe, from what I read. This is a Necroniclast with Haven. Really really cool art right there. It almost kind of reminds me of the cover for Dizma's album. And this is Ashes. And lastly, The Plague. Really dig that artwork out of all of them, I think. Oop, got lost the booklet there. Next up, I Shall Become with Requiem. Another black metal band that I actually discovered not long ago, it seems like. Got their debut, and I found this in there. I was like, hell yeah, another I Shall Become. Then we have Azag Hall with Omega. Pretty cool symbol there. And the next three are by the same band. And this is one of the ones that I knew who they were, and I've heard some of their music, though I know their first album was more like a kind of epic, heavy metal, power metal type sound, and then they switched to more of a black and black and death metal, which I haven't listened to too much out of that era of the band, but for $5, like I said, worth a shot. This is Satan's Host with Great American Scapegoat. Interesting artwork there. By the Hands of the Devil. And lastly, Power, Purity, Perfection 999. And the last one. And this is the one that I was most excited to pick up because, as I said in the beginning, this is kind of a newer holy grail item for me. I read about it again, as I mentioned in some of my other videos here recently. Dial Patterson's book, and one of the first sections in the new book was on Satyricon. And I read that Satyr had released a solo album back in, I believe it was 95. And thought, let me see if, you know, that's still available. Of course, long out of print. It did get a reissue in 2002. That's out of print. And even the vinyl, of course, out of print. And I did see on Discogs there were some copies that were like $14.95 or some shit. And hard telling if, you know, what condition they're in, which version they are and everything. But in general, most of the times that I saw this, it was like way up there, way, way up there. And most people have told me that it was damn near impossible to find. And for a couple of years now, Brett has had a couple boxes full of CDs where somebody basically sold off, looks like, their entire metal collection. I've picked through it here and there, and there's a lot of stuff in there. It's original pressings, and it's really hard to find stuff, and of course it's pretty expensive, and this one was no exception. It was not cheap by any means, but again, I had store credit, so it really didn't matter to me, and when I saw this, I damn near shit a brick. But this is Wohngraven with Fjelltrinen. Again, this is Satyr from Satyricon's lone solo album, playing a kind of folky, ambient style of black metal, and this here is the original OG 1995, I believe it is, pressing, and you can tell that because I looked up the reissue from 2002, and the photo is a close-up of this. The logo looks a little bit different, and it is actually down here. And everything that I could look up on this says that this is the original pressing. And, of course, I had to change the case out because the case was kind of nasty looking. But the disc and everything else is in mint condition. I could not fucking believe this was in there. As soon as I saw it, I grabbed it and I told Brett, I know this is not going to be cheap, but I want this. And he actually cut me a deal on it, which, again, even the deal was still pretty expensive. But, like I said, I had store credit, which took care of this and a couple others. I am just so fucking happy to have this in my collection right now, and I know a couple people that I've told about this are kind of jealous of it, but yeah, if you get a chance to hear this, definitely check it out. This is just so fucking good. So yeah, that is going to do it until I get another chance to go to 13th floor, which will probably be sometime next year unless something else happens that I get up that way. So that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching and subscribing, and until next time, stay brutal.